Hunter, my name is Michael Merchant. I hear that you saw a giant snake.
Oh, yes. He was a big one.
Sir, do I have your permission to record this? What I would like to do is do this interview with you, and I would like to put the interview on YouTube so that other people that are interested in this sort of thing, you know, can get a firsthand account from you. Would that be okay?
Okay. Yes, sir. That's fine.
Hunter, could you tell us your name?
Kenneth Hunter.
Now, you had an encounter with a giant snake, I understand. Where did that happen?
It was back in Steinahatchee down here. It was way back in there, what they call Steinahatchee Reserve, back in down here in Florida, between Old Town and Cross City.
Now, is that at the northern part of Florida, or where is that in Florida?
Yeah, that's here in Florida. I don't know if you've ever heard of Old Town and Cross City or not.
No, sir, I haven't.
Well, they're over there on the coast, in the Gulf Coast.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of rural area back in there. You got all kinds of, you know, you can just drive forever and ever in there in them woods and, you know, never hardly ever run into anybody. I've drove in there for days at a time and never seen nobody.
Wow. Is it like swampy in that neck of the woods?
Yeah. There's a lot of hunting, you know, gators. Oh, we used to get gators all the time until the law got so bad, you know, on that. Had to quit that.
Right. Now, what were you guys doing? I guess you were like the edge of a swamp or something when you saw this critter. What were you guys up in there woodcutting?
Yeah, it was in some real swampy area. And he was coming across a little tram road. It was just a road big enough, you know, for one vehicle to go through. And when we saw it, or first, you know, we weren't paying no attention. We just saw it was a damn log there, you know, a big limb or something across the road. And we run over the damn thing, you know, and boom, you know, and that sucker, his head come up. He come out of the ditch over there, ever was, you know, the up on the driver's side. His head did right up into the damn window.
Wow.
And boy, I'm telling you, you know, it was, it just shocked the hell out of us because we weren't expecting nothing like that, you know. And anyhow, but he just come right there. We're sitting on him, and he backed up off of him. And the snake still was trying to come through the goddamn window. His head was hitting the window. He done rolled his window up. And by the time we got around there, got our heads collected together, well, the snake was moving on off. And he had a .45, and he got a shot at him several times. I mean, it so shook up, I guess he never did hit him, you know.
Right.
But he was, best I could tell, he had kind of like a flat bottom on him, you know, big round on the top, but kind of had like a flat bottom to him.
Mm-hmm.
It weren't, you know, his bottom weren't, you know, where he crawled, or his belly weren't rounded like a regular snake. It was a more flat colored, flat looking snake on the bottom of him.
That's an interesting detail, Hunter. About how long would you estimate the length of this snake was?
Oh, hell, he had to be 23 feet long, had to be.
Wow, that's a big snake.
Because he was slapping across that damn roadway, and then when we went to, you know, because we saw the limb, he was eased up on him, was going to roll over it, you know, thinking it was a log there, you know, a limb. But hell, when he hit that thing, that damn dude, he hit that damn snake head come right up there to his damn window, you know, almost beat him, you know. And I'd heard my grandpa talk about some snakes back when he was, when they were, you know, using old mule skids and things, making right-of-ways and stuff, you right. know. And he had talked about that. They killed some big snake in there. They didn't know what it was. But he drug him up to the house, you know, behind the old mule and everything he had. They were, you know how they used to use mules with scoop pans.
I'm not real familiar with the use of mules, Hunter, but I have some idea what you're talking about.
Yeah.
That's a bit before my time. I haven't had a lot of, you know, I didn't use mules very much.
Yeah. But anyhow, it's been years ago, you know, even my grandpa.
Mm-hmm.
And he was an old man when he set him up. He drug him home and went out there and told his wife to go there and look at that damn snake that he had. And he went out there, or she went out there, she wasn't screaming, hollering. And evidently the other snake, its mate, or ever what it was, had followed it up there. And anyhow, he got away, that snake got away from him, but he tried to kill him, but he couldn't, you know, because the one he had up there was about 14 foot long, he said.
Damn. So they killed one snake that was 14 foot long, and another snake of similar size followed them?
Yeah, had followed, you know, I guess, you know, because he'd come in late, you know, and just had drug him up on the tractor, I mean, on the mule skid pan and all, and had drug him up there. And they was eating supper and all that, and he just told her to go out and look at that snake. You know, he'd never seen nothing like that. And she went out and went screaming, and those snake had followed it up there.
Wow. Now, you guys, I get the impression you guys grew up down there and you hung out in the swamp and stuff. Is it a safe thing to say that you guys knew most of the snakes in the area? Did you know what species they were and stuff?
Oh, yeah, I knew about every kind of snake you would, except that one. I ain't got no idea in the world what that thing was.
Wow.
I've never seen nothing like that.
Hunter, what color would you just... Did the creature have, like, a distinct color? Did it have a pattern? Is there anything that you can tell me about what the snake looked like, you know, that would help me?
He had, grayish, it was black and gray, blackish gray, really.
Mm-hmm.
So blackish, had a lot of gray, but more gray than black. But it had like black markings in him. But it was mostly he was gray, but it had some, you know, some black in him, but mostly he was gray.
Did you get, great. You said the head was up near the window. Did you perchance notice any detail about the eyes, the color of the eyes, the shape of the pupil, anything like that?
Not really. Everything happened so damn fast, you know. I remember he had a hole of mouth on him. I know that because I seen his. After he got the window rolled up, his mouth kept hitting the damn window, you know.
Right.
And,
so how big was its head?
Oh, hell, I bet his head is probably as big as a decent-sized bulldog's head.
His head was as big as a bulldog's head?
Well, you know, yeah. I mean, you know, decent, not a great big bulldog, but just a nice-sized bulldog.
Wow.
He had a big head on him now.
When you guys said you drove the truck right over this thing, about how big around was it in its biggest section? You know, how like the thickest part of it?
He was at least, like, 8-inch shoe with the round on him with kind of the flat-looking bottom to him. But he was good 8 inches through.
Wow.
And his big part of his body, he was a good 8 inches. I mean, a good 8 inches.
Now, when that's you said he was kind of flat-bottomed, is that kind of like if you took a loaf of bread, you know, when you're making bread, and it kind of lays down like that? Is that
about like a loaf of bread. I mean, his bottom, his belly weren't rounded like a, you know, like a regular some steaks, you know. He just had that flat bottom to him. I don't remember that being real good. He just had a flat bottom to him and a big ass, a good 8 inches through, you know what I mean? But he just had that flat bottom. I can remember that flat bottom about him.
Hunter, what do you think would happen if, you know, somebody was off in the swamp by themselves and weren't armed and that thing decided to attack a person? Who do you think would come out the victor? Who would win?
I'd have Snake would. There ain't no doubt about that. There ain't no doubt about that.
You'd be voting for the Snake, huh?
He was aggressive as hell.
Wow.
He's real aggressive.
Now, when you said, here's another thing that I want to discuss, because I don't know if you're aware of this now, but about 10 years ago or so in South Florida, there was a lot of Burmese pythons released. But if I understand correctly, this encounter you had with this snake happened quite a long time ago, right?
Oh, yeah. That's probably 20, 25 years ago.
Okay, so maybe 1980 or 1990, somewhere along there, you think it might have happened? Or further back?
Yeah, it was on back there.
Back in the 80s?
It's been at least 20 years or so.
But now the encounter that your grandfather had, that would have been even, I mean, how long ago did that happen?
Oh, Lord, that was way shit. I would have been back in the real early 1900s, probably, you know.
And that's in that same area that you're telling me about, huh?
Yeah, it's in the same, about the same area. I mean, you know, not the same area, but in that vicinity within, you know, 50, 60 miles or so.
Now, this area you're talking about on the Gulf Coast, is it up near the Panhandle or is it further down to the Everglades?
No, it's coming on down, I was just trying to think. It's on down, no, not up there. Damn, I was just trying to think what other towns. Well, it's Chiefland, I'm just trying to think, it's Chiefland and, Cross City Old Town, Swanee Town and, Lord, I was trying to.
I'm just trying to understand, though. Are these areas in the northern part of the state of Florida or more southern?
It's just kind of more up, I'd say a little more north.
Okay.
They know more north. That'd probably be about a third down, you know what I mean?
Right.
On the coast, you know, the Gulf Coast, how it comes around.
Yep. Well, that's remarkable. Do you, in this area, I mean, obviously, if your grandfather, was this something that other people had seen these giant snakes in this area?
Yeah, we'd heard other people say they'd seen one, you know, before that. When I was down, we'd seen that one. We'd heard that tale that they had, you know, that's what we called it. We just thought it was a bullshit tale, you know.
Right.
That's how we run into him. And I don't know if it's the same one or no or what, but they said, hey, the way they had told it, you know, it was because the sucker went slap across the road and just, you know what I mean, never even, you know, weren't no, you couldn't see his end either way, you know, on a little old tram road. You couldn't see the end of his tail or his head until we started to ease over him, and then, boy, he come just right up on the damn truck, you know.
That must have startled you guys.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, damn sure did. I wasn't believing it, you know what I mean? Right. You know, it's hard to tell, but that's what we always just say. That's just bullshit, you know?
Right.
And until we run into it, and then we realize it weren't no bullshit, you know?
Wow, that's amazing. Hunter, did the shape of the... You've described the snake's head as being fairly large. Did it look like a regular snake to you, or did the head look different than a normal snake?
No, it didn't look like a normal head. I mean, you know, like one of our smaller little snakes, like we have 7-8 footers, whatever, what, you know, the bigger ones that we got, but it didn't, he had a goddamn, I don't know, a damn head kind of, I don't know, it kind of come around, but kind of didn't have no real sharp point to it, but it had a little bit of a sharper point right where his mouth was at, but it weren't, you know, it weren't no real sharp points, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, so the nose was somewhat pointed, but not super pointed?
Right, right.
That's interesting. Well, I find that very fascinating. I am glad that you took the opportunity to share this with us. Your son, Justin, has told me, or is it Jason? I call him Dixie, so I don't know what his what his real name is, but he's told me he's heard this story a lot.
Oh, yeah. He's been him, boy. We used to run them woods a lot together.
Now, do you know, are there still woods down there, or have they turned around and built that area all up?
But I miss that.
Well, do you, in this area where you saw the snake 20, 30 years ago, do you think that there's still swamp land there?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, most definitely. Yeah, that's still all swamp in there. That place is rural as hell. There ain't nobody lives in there around in that area.
Right.
It's rural, you know, it's like just hundreds and hundreds of acres of just nothing but the wilderness, you know what I mean?
So what do you think? Do you think there's a chance there still could be, you know, some big snakes living in that swamp even today?
Well, I know there's one, and if there's one, there's got to be two, you know?
That's right.
That's all that I can say, you know. I know there'd have to be two if there's one.
No, you're absolutely right, Hunter. If there's one of them, there's probably a population of them in there.
Well, that's the only time I ever run into one like that, though. I tell you what, them down there, the shows on them down there, them pythons all down in the Everglades now.
Right.
And you know, they're talking about there's the anacondas down there now, too.
Right, and anacondas. You know,
the anaconda.
Mm-hmm.
They say there's you know, they got a green, what they call a green anaconda.
Yes, sir.
And they say that they've seen them in there. A green anaconda and, you know, and the regular, that's what they call an anaconda.
In the spot where you saw the giant snake, they've now reported anacondas in there?
No, I don't think he would know.
Oh, you're talking about the Everglades.
No, that was down in the Everglades I was talking about. Right. This here was further up this way, yeah.
Yeah, no, I think it's important.
Guess it could have been no damn anaconda. I never thought about that. You know, I hadn't even thought about that, but it was a big sucker. It had to be at least 20, 22 feet long.
Yeah, that's a really big, that's a huge snake.
20, 22, 23, it had to be a bit of that long.
See, the thing is, Hunter, I know a lot of people would immediately say, well, it's probably a released python, but the reason that I think that you might have saw a snake that was indigenous to the area, in other words, native to that area, but just hasn't been reported, is the simple fact that you're telling me that your grandfather killed one that was 14 feet long many, many, many years ago.
Yeah.
So that would kind of eliminate these released pythons, because these have only been, you know, python the Burmese pythons, Python muralis bivitatis, and the reticulated python, Python reticulatus, and the anaconda. All three of those snakes have only been in the pet trade probably in the last, 15, 20 years. So it's unlikely that's what you saw. It probably saw something even stranger.
Yeah.
Really amazing.
Yeah, I've seen all them, I've watched all the shows on the pythons. They weren't nothing like those pythons.
Right.
I mean, it wasn't like no python or nothing.
Well, I appreciate you taking the time to talk to us, and I'm going to get back to Dixie Comic. I'm going to find out the exact location where you had that sighting, and if I get half a chance when I'm down in Florida, I'm going to go investigate that swamp, because accounts like you've shared with me tonight, I find extremely interesting, because as odd as it is, there are people all across the United States that report seeing these really giant snakes, and they've reported them for over 100 years.
Damn.
So I think there's something to it,
Yeah.
And they're always in areas like you're in where nobody lives.
Yeah, well, see, that's what we thought. We'd heard that tale down there before, but mm-hmm. And we didn't pay no attention until we run into it that day.
Right. All right, well, I'm going to stop recording here. Hold on a second. I want to thank you again, Hunter.